In your first programming class, computer memory may have been explained to you with a picture that looks something like this. We have the CPU, where your instructions get executed, and these instructions may read or write to either main memory or to disk. Main memory is fast, and you can access any element in the same amount of time. That's what we mean by random access. And it is temporary in the sense that when the program exits, or if power is lost, all the information stored in it disappears. The hard disk, by contrast, is slow. It uses sequential access, since you have to actually spin the disk to the right place, and what you write to the disk is permanent. It will still be there when the program exits, or if power is lost. In this lecture, we're going to refine this picture in two ways. First, we'll look at cache systems, which allow the CPU to access the same information that is in main memory, only faster. Understanding how cache systems work will help you optimize your code when you need to. Second, we will explain the virtual memory system. As you write your application and a compiler compiles it to generate addresses for all your variables and your code, you don't have to worry about other programs and what memory addresses they might be using. In fact, there's often an illusion of having even more main memory than exists in the system, and that your application has them all to itself. We'll see how the operating system maintains this abstraction through the virtual memory system. The details are essential to understanding operating system optimizations and how the need to share resources affects program performance.